Good morning, Connect Church. It is May 24th. We're so glad that you joined us today. Again, we're meeting in the building right now. We've been meeting for the last 2 weeks. This will be our third week in the building, but we wanted to continue to provide this online service for you, for all those who feel like you just need to stay home. We understand. We don't want you to feel pressure at all to come into the building, to come to a service at the building. We want you to be able to make a wise decision for you and your family, whatever you think is best. And so we're going to continue to do these online services for you. We'll continue to do services in the building right now. And Wednesday night, we are doing youth services, but we're not doing children's services yet on Wednesday night. So anybody who is 7th through 12th grade, we would love to have you on Wednesday nights. But for everybody else, we're not going to do any Wednesday night services for our children or any of the small groups or anything during the week. We'll pick that up in the fall by the time school starts. And so that's kind of our plan. But today we're going to continue our sermon series called Don't Be Stupid. So we're coming out of the book of Proverbs. And last week when I announced that in the service, I said, don't be stupid. I had somebody scream back, it's too late. And I understand. I feel that way too sometimes. It's those things in our life that we wish we could go back and redo, but we can't. There's no redos in life. But what we can do is take what we learn from Scripture, apply it to our lives so that we don't make the same mistakes. And so I understand if you feel like, hey, it's too late for me. I've already done some stupid things. Look, we all have. But what we're going to do is we continue to look into the book of Proverbs. We're going to learn how to live a wise life. And so today we're going to be in Proverbs chapter 10, and we're going to be reading verses 8 through 10. And so if you have your Bible, just read with us. But here it says, a wise heart accepts commands, but foolish chattering destroys you. Verse 9, anyone who lives without blame walks safely, but anyone who takes a crooked path will get caught. And in verse 10, an evil wink gets you into trouble, and foolish chattering destroys you. So there's a line in there that is used twice. We'll talk about that in just a little bit. But the first thing it says is a wise heart accepts commands. Now, we talked about this a little bit last week where we talked about you must be teachable. You must be willing to learn. You know, one of the first things that you have to do is get to that place where you say, God's word is the authority in my life. I'm not the authority in my life, but God's word is, and I am willing to learn from Scripture. I don't know if you've ever taught somebody that thought they already knew everything or thought they knew how to do what you were trying to teach them, but it really made it impossible for them to learn, because as you were trying to show them, as you were trying to show them how to do whatever it is you were teaching them, what they were thinking of is how they were going to tell you how it's done. Now, look, I learned a valuable lesson when I was younger. You know, I lived in Virginia. I got to be around in just the state there, just some important people within the churches and within the state. And I would, when I went into a meeting with them, or if I got to meet them, I would go in and I would talk. I mean, I would talk a lot. I would tell them about all the great things that I was doing. I would tell them about how I'd gotten an education. I would do all those things. And somebody came to me one time and said, listen, what you need to do is stop trying to impress them. These people are very successful. Take the time, close your mouth, and listen to them and learn from them. And so I took that advice. And anytime I'm around someone I think is successful in any area, and it doesn't have to necessarily be in the Christian arena or within the church, if I see that they're successful in some part of life, I try to ask as many questions as possible and listen to them. The person who told me that changed my perspective in life, really, where I need to be one that is teachable. I don't need to think that I know everything, because if I try to impress and think that I know it all, then I can't learn anything. And so here in Scripture, it says a wise heart accepts commands. You have to have a heart that's ready to accept the commands of God. And if your heart's not ready to do that, then you're going to have a hard time learning. You have people who've read their Bible their whole life, but they really haven't learned because their heart is not teachable. They're really in the Bible trying to, I guess, shore up their opinion, find support for their opinion. trying to find verses that will support what they think is correct instead of looking into the Word of God and saying, God, correct my thinking. And that's what we have to do. We have to go to God's Word and say, correct my thinking. Correct the way that I understand the world. Correct the way that I understand my relationship with the people around me. God, correct me from your word how I have a relationship with you. What are the things that I'm doing wrong? And that's what we have to do. We have to have a teachable heart. And so if you don't have that, the book of Proverbs or any of the books in the scripture, they're not going to be able to change your life. Okay, so first things first, a wise heart accepts commands. Look, take this as a way to better your relationship with God and better your relationship with people around you. And a lot of times we think, because none of us want to be wrong, we think, oh, I can't be wrong. And if I say that I'm wrong in this area, then I'm showing weakness to people around you or around me, or I'm showing that I'm not very intelligent. And what I would tell you is, very intelligent people, as they find truth, they change their opinion. So what I'm asking you is to have a heart that's willing to see God's word as truth and accept it as truth and change your life to meet what God's word says. And so that's the first thing, okay? And then it goes on, it says, but foolish chattering destroys you. And here's what we were just talking about. This is this foolish chattering where people, and you may know these people, and hopefully you're not this person, but they like to talk about themselves all the time. They like to talk about how great they are. They like to talk about how great their accomplishments are. They like to talk about just foolishness in the sense of truth, okay? So they may start off, I don't know what you would do, but this is what I did, and they don't base it anything on scripture. Now, if they base what they did on scripture and say, I don't know about you, but here's what God's word taught me, and this is how I reacted, now that's a different story. But for the most part, in the generation that we live in, in the culture that we live in, it seems that people want to be heard, and they think the more that they're heard, the more that whatever they're saying is, the more their opinion is truth. And that's not true at all. We talked about this last week, that there's only one truth, and that one truth is the Word of God. It doesn't matter how many times you say the world's flat, the world's not flat. So if I have any flat earthers out there, I'm sorry to break the news to you. The world, the earth, is a sphere. And so we have to make sure that we aren't listening to this foolish chatter. Just because we hear it over and over and over, just because you hear something multiple times doesn't make it true. What makes something true is where that originates from. Like, don't trust anything that comes from Facebook. Don't trust that information. You never know. It's kind of funny when you look at Facebook, everybody's life looks incredible, doesn't it? And that's really not what reality is. Reality is most people have their ups and their downs, and they're struggling and having these hard times, but we only put out what we want people to see. So not to say that Facebook is bad, but that's not the most reliable place to find information. What we need to do is make sure that the source of information, the source of truth for us, isn't this foolish chattering, but it is God. It is centered in the truths of God, okay? So, but the foolish chattering destroys you, and it's that advice. It is that advice that's not based on any type of wisdom from God. It's not based on the scripture that will destroy you. Do not listen to those voices that are in your life that try to tell you truth or say, give you a false truth and say, hey, this is what I think. And they just keep chattering, but they never give you or show you how their opinion is based on the Word of God. But listen to and always be ready for your heart to accept the commands from the Word of God. So those people that are speaking into your life and saying, here is what the Word of God says. Listen to those people. Those people are giving you truth. So let your heart be ready to accept truth that's based on the Word of God, and be ready to reject that foolish chattering that's based on worldly wisdom or just our opinion or how we think that we are great. So do that. Now, in verse 9, it continues. It says, anyone who lives without blame walks safely, but anyone who takes a crooked path will get caught. Look, it's just saying, if you live a blameless life, you live in safety. There's a lot of things that come with safety. One of those is peace. If you live this blameless life, this life without blame, then you don't have to be worried about being exposed. But then it says, hey, anyone who takes a crooked path will get caught. You know, there have been times in my life that I've done things that weren't right. And probably some of the worst, or I know the worst part of it is, will I get caught? Am I going to get caught? And when I did get caught, what was that like? It wasn't a life of peace. So in the whole time that I was doing these things in my life, I didn't have peace. I didn't feel safe. I didn't feel secure. I didn't have a peace of mind. My heart was always restless. And so it's this idea that as we walk in the worldly ways, as we look at this foolish chatter, we know that we're going to get caught, that this wisdom will catch up with us. But it says, if you live according to the word of God, that you can walk in safety. It will give you peace. It will give you comfort. You think of the 23rd Psalm, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. And so there's this idea that the Lord, as he leads us and guides us, gives us comfort in because of his guidance and because of his safety. And so it tells us, hey, make sure you're walking without blame and don't walk amongst the crooked paths. And then finally in verse 10, it tells us that an evil wink gets you into trouble, and foolish chattering destroys you. And so here's the thing, an evil wink, and I don't know if you've ever seen that, it's where somebody's just crying, you know, they're like, hey, here's what we're going to do. Now, I've given those evil winks towards people when we're trying to play a trick on them. You know, you walk in and you go, hey, you know, whatever it is, and you wink at them. You're trying to get people to go along with you so that you play a trick on something or whatever. But it's actually saying even more than that. It's saying, hey, there are these people who are trying to deceive you and trying to deceive you secretly, and that they're going to come along and bring trouble into your life. So be aware of that. Be aware that there are those people that are secretly going to try to destroy your life, because an evil wink gets you into trouble. And don't go along with, and be mindful of those people. Be mindful of those. And who are those people? And foolish chattering destroys you. Those are those people that live in the world, that live according to their own opinions, not based on scripture at all. Those people who will reject the ways of God and the words of God, and man, they may be loud, and we have a lot of loud voices in our society right now, in our culture. And it seems like, to me, a lot of those voices that are really loud are very ungodly. And they believe that if they're super loud, that they win the argument. Look, I have friends, family, they used to argue, or they still do argue, and they think if they can scream the loudest and they can be louder than you, then they win the argument. So if they're really loud, they're just bringing the volume up, and they're getting louder and louder, and they just scream you down, well, they've won the argument. And that's just not true. Just because someone's loud doesn't make them right. And so we have to make sure that this foolish chattering and these people that are trying to trick us don't destroy us. And how do we do that? The very first thing, a wise heart accepts commands. We root ourselves in the word of God. How is it that, how can you not be tricked? Well, you root yourself in the word of God. How is it that you know, there's these paths and you're not sure which path to take, which choice in life to take? And you know, one may be a blameless, and one's going to be a blameless path, and one will be a crooked path. And like, which one do I take? You root yourself into the word of God. You have to let your heart accept the commands of God. And once you apply those to your life, then you can live a safe life. But if you live walking according to a crooked path, surrounding yourself with people that are trying to deceive you or trick you or get you into trouble, then your life will be destroyed. So here's what I'm going to say to you. Be teachable. That's the only way to be protected, to be rooted in the Word of God, so that when people come to try to deceive you, when people come to try to talk your ear off until they can tell you or convince you that they're right, or scream you down or yell you down, what I would tell you is root yourself into the Word of God, and then your life will be directed by God, and you have this promise that you will walk safely, and when it means safely, in peace. And so in the worst of times, when things aren't safe physically, spiritually, there will be a safety and a comfort and a peace that we talked about just a few weeks ago, a peace that surpasses all understanding because your heart accepted the commands of God. Anyway, until next week, I would challenge you to memorize some scripture. That's one of the greatest ways to do this, to accept the commands of God, that your heart would accept the commands of God, is memorize some scripture. You know, the scripture tells us that, the scripture says, I hide your word in my heart that I may not sin against God. And so what I would say is hide God's word in your heart that you may not sin against God, so you will know how to walk rightly. So until next week, I hope that you memorize some scripture, maybe just one, you know, maybe just one this whole month, or, you know, some of you are very good at memorizing things, and so maybe you can memorize more than that. Some of you may even memorize maybe a whole book for the month. So you're at home, you don't have a lot to do, and so you just memorize, I don't know, you memorize the book of Romans. If you did that, that would be incredible. Or some of you, if you just memorize one scripture this week or this month because you have a difficult time memorizing, that would be great. Okay, so don't let the how much you memorize affect that you start. Look, if it's one, that's one more verse that you have that can help you walk in a right way. So let your heart accept the commands of God. I'll see you guys next week.